think about the generations and to say we want to make it a better place for our children and our children's children so that they know it's a better world for them and think if they can make it a better place.
A communication disorder is a problem in language, speech, or hearing. Impairments include articulation disorders, language disorders, fluency disorders, or speech or language delay.
It's like social language skills, like what to do or say in problem situations. A lot of times we'll work on, I'll read a story, they have to identify the problem, and then think of solutions or ways to solve the problem. That's what language pragmatics is. And for the really young kids that have a language disorder that don't have language at all, we just start working on naming nouns and then building on that. Then after that, we might do like action words and verbs and then try to work on building sentences just to give them language. And if it was like an older student that was like maybe 12 or so and they hadn't started speaking, we would work on signs to give them language. And that would still be like language therapy because you need to give them any sort of language you can.
Characteristics that you see with people with communication disorders. Some patients have problems following directions. Some patients have problems with pronouncing things properly. Some have incomprehensible speech, which we call unintelligibility, which you can't understand what is being said. With stuttering, the speech is very disfluent. It is not fluid. With voice disorders, some people have breathiness or hoarseness in their voice, and a person that's listening to the speech of that person can tell something is wrong. With hearing, if a patient has a hearing impairment, they might tend to become disconnected in conversation, or they might ask for you to constantly repeat things.
For the number of kids that a speech therapist might see in one day, it depends on the setting. Here in the private setting, it's one-on-one therapy. So if you got here at 9 and worked till about 5, I guess you'll probably see about 8 kids. I would say in my elementary school, I'm about 500 kids. My caseload is about 45. If you were just doing therapy, if you had to do an evaluation, it might be a little bit less because those take longer. They only take up to an hour, and therapy sessions are 30 minutes long. But in the school setting, I start at 8 o'clock and go until 3, and I see in the groups about 3, so about 8 groups of 3, so that's about 24 kids a day.
In a regular session for articulation students, an example would be we would take vocabulary picture cards that are strictly focused on that one sound. So let's just say we're working on K, and we have all these vocabulary picture cards with K in the initial position, the medial position, and the final position, and we have them all face down on a table. We spread them out. If you have a group of children, we can also practice turn-taking skills. You're interacting with other students. A child that suffers from apraxia, you might have to do more one-on-one treatment. It just depends. When a child is ARDed into special education, they have an admission review and dismissal meeting. They pick speech goals and objectives that have to be worked on in each of these speech therapy sessions, along with how long and how many minutes per grading period that the child needs to be serviced. Communication disorders can be treated depending on what the communication disorder is. You have a greater outcome of a better prognosis of overcoming the communication disorder. But speech therapy is not an end-all, it's not a cure-all for for every situation and every child. In some therapy sessions, you teach strategies to deal with the communication disorder, or depending on if it's like an articulation child, you work on that sound until that child masters that sound, and that way therapy does do away with the disorder itself. But sometimes therapy is just giving a patient tools to live or deal with their communication disorder. It does not always completely cure